Hi friends, in this video I'm going to explain how to create a nice interactive chat using form control and if formula nested with Vlookup formula. To create this chart, I'm using combination chart option using secondary access. The final output of this chart will be like this. Currently the chart is blank and there are three checkboxes: revenue, gross profit and net profit margin. If I select revenue, the revenue is appearing, the columns are appearing only for revenue, and then if I select gross profit, and then gross profit columns are appearing, and finally if I select net profit margin is appearing as a line. But anytime if I want to show one element to the audience, I can simply uncheck revenue. If you don't want to show revenue, I can uncheck it, or if I want to show only net profit margin line, I can remove gross profit as well. So I can show whatever element I want based on the selection of the checkbox. Now let us see how to create this chart very quickly. To create the chart, I'm using this data, which is containing revenue, gross profit and net margin for several years. But before getting into the chart, I need to get checkboxes and I need to give a control to them. So for that I need to go to developer tab, under that control section, and I'm selecting insert option and selecting the checkbox from form controls option. Selected the checkbox and then drag on Excel. So checkbox is created. I need to create two more checkboxes. For that I need not go to developer tab again. I can simply copy paste this checkbox so that another copy can be created. Otherwise, select it and control drag, and again select it, control drag, the copies will be created. Now I need to name these checkboxes. So first I am aligning them in a proper place. And then I can edit the text first. Right click on the checkbox, go to edit text option, remove the name and name it as revenue. The second checkbox, edit text, and then gross profit. Again, edit text, net profit margin. Now I need to give a control to these three checkboxes. For that, right click on the form control, that is checkbox, and format control option. So select the colors and lines tab. Under that, go to fill option, color option, select a color, and then go to control option, control tab. In that, select cell link and give a link to it. I am selecting F1 and say OK. Now what happens? If I select revenue checkbox, automatically F1 will be filled with true now. True. And then if I remove the checkbox and check tick mark on the checkbox, it will become false. True, false, true, false. So that way one control option is created. So automatically it is creating true or false. In the same way, I need to do other also. Format control, select link, selecting G1, and go to colors and then give a different color. Likewise, net profit margin, format control, go to control, select the cell link option and select H, and then colors and lines, and then give a fill to it. Say OK. Now once you check on each box, so now all the three references are showing true, and if I remove them, all are showing as false. Now your checkboxes are created. Next thing, we need to create the data point for a chart with if and VLOOKUP nesting. To create a dynamic chart, I need to create another data set. For that purpose, I'm just copying all the column headers and pasting them below the true or false created by checkboxes. And then all the ears and placing them at a required place. Now I need to use a if formula along with VLOOKUP. So if formula is asking a logical test, these are the arguments, logical test, value if true and value if false. So if F1, so what I'm trying to say is if F1 is equal to true, so I need not write F1 is equal to true. If I select if F1, automatically Excel can understand that it is a logical field, so true. That means this much I can write. So here I am making row constant and column relative. So F1. So automatically when I put this formula to G column, automatically the reference should be taking the G1 value. So if I say this, Excel can understand that if F1 is equal to true. If it is true, I need to put a VLOOKUP value, VLOOKUP. And this is a lookup value and column constant, comma, selecting the range of table array and making that also constant, comma. Instead of using index, column index number 2, 3, 4, I'm using a formula, columns. Columns. And then I need to give an array. That means I'm selecting a cell reference and then colon. Then the formula will be coming like this, making the first cell reference as constant. So now it is columns E3 to E3. It gives me 1, a value 1. When you write this formula in any empty cell, you'll get a value 1. So now I need to make here as 2. So if I write 2 here, I'll get the value of revenue here, right? So I'm writing 1, comma, false. So that means I'm writing VLOOKUP E3, A22 D8, that is the table array, columns E3 to E3 plus 1 means I'm getting a value 2 and then false. Otherwise, now I need to give a false value. So if the cell F1 is equal to true, then there should be a VLOOKUP. Otherwise, it has to be silent. And then close bracket. Now the values are coming up. Let me see whether all the values are made constant. Now the formula is if F1, comma, that means if F1 is equal to true, then I need to put a VLOOKUP. That is, lookup value is the year. And then lookup array is all the data. And then instead of putting constants 2, 3, 4 as index column value, column index number, I'm writing columns E3 to E3 plus 1. And the first E3 is constant. When I put this formula towards, in G3, the formula is now, you can see, the columns formula is now dragged to E3 to F3. Because E3 I made as constant and second E3 I made as relative. So automatically it is dragged and now it is E3 to F3. Which will give me 2 number plus 1, 3. So gross profit is in the third column. Accordingly, I'm getting the value. So now I can simply select the range. Press Control D. Sorry, I need to select the range. Control D, Control R. Now I need to make these as percentages. Now my data is ready. If I use the checkbox, the data will behave the way it is required. Now I am selecting, unchecking the revenue. Now revenue is disappearing. If I uncheck gross profit disappears. If I uncheck net profit margin, that data also disappears. So this is the logic behind the dynamic chart. Now I am selecting all the checkboxes. Now data is here. I am now selecting a chart. Insert. And then go to all chart option. There, select a combo chart. In that, revenue will be clustered column chart, gross profit will be clustered column chart, but net margin will be a line chart and it will be in secondary axis. Now the chart is ready. I can format it. Now I don't want to show the data to anybody and rather I want to show only the chart. Now for that, I'm just selecting data table as well. So that data table is ready now, and make the chart little good looking. Removing the chart title, it is not required now for me. Now if I select revenue, uncheck revenue, revenue data is disappearing, only gross profit is appearing. If I uncheck gross profit, accordingly the gross profit columns are also missing. And if I say net margin, net margin is also missing and the chart is empty. If I wanted to present to anybody, if I say revenue, I want to show only revenue, then I say revenue. If I select revenue, automatically revenue column is alone shown up. And if I wanted to show only gross profit, I can just select gross profit. And if I wanted to show only net margin, I can select only net margin, the checkbox checked. Accordingly, I can automate the data. Hope you understood how to create this chart. And if you have any questions, kindly let me know. Put your comments in the comment section so that I can contact you and I can answer your questions. Also, you can always contact me through this email ID. And I'm always available to answer your questions. And if you like this video, please share this video and subscribe. And of course, keep watching my videos. Thank you very much.